My name is Andi and I'm an engineer here at Sintratec. We are a Swiss startup that makes SLS 3D printers. We have a new machine coming up, the Sintratec S2. So as you might expect, we are doing a lot of testing with it right now. To demonstrate the strength of its parts, I designed a functional electric ducted fan driven by an 800 watts RC brushless in-runner motor. Our goal was to see how much power the part could handle without being damaged. Once the design was done, I printed the part with our strong PA12. Next, I balanced the fan with some lead balls around the rotation axis. Soon I was able to hold a prototype in my hands that was ready to be tested. For that, I tied the EDF to a metal cord and mounted it onto a rail, which I clamped on a table. The proper safety distance and wearing safety goggles, I started the engine and increased the speed slowly step by step. However, we decided to abort the test at around quarter the full speed because we were worried about all the powder coming out of the front. After investigating, it was clear that this resulted from a design flaw, where a small inner area was not closed. For the print to sustain the resulting forces, stability was a crucial aspect, but not easy to achieve. In my first prototype, I left the shell hollow, which resulted in the EDF being too soft and pliable. So I had to enforce the interior walls with additional structures. After printing the part again, we were ready to redo the test. This time I fixed the EDF onto a more stable workbench and increased the power again. But then I noticed an imbalance of its spinner. To make sure it was stable, I decided to remove it and continue without that. We also added some smoke to visualize the airflow. The peak power was about 1400 watts, an impressive result in my opinion, considering the motor has a nominal power of 800 watts and the EDF survived it without any damage at all. I think this test showed how the strength of the Sintratec PA12 powder combined with the efficiency of our S2 makes for very durable prints.